Olha lá!
Gente, estamos aqui outra vez!
Com Olha Lá!
Olha lá! Check it out! Eu sou Orlando.
E eu sou a Andriana.
You can tell which one's which on the photo, I'm sure.
Essa foto nunca muda, né? Temos que mudar essa foto.
We do need to get a new updated photograph. With your daughter, perhaps. Catarina. Anyway, we are here with another episode of Olha Lá, where we show you photographs from Brazil and give you a little bit of background to help you understand them along the way. Usually it means I don't understand something and you describe it for me.
Vamos lá, então.
Today, I took a picture walking down the street in São João do Rei, in Minas Gerais. This is a person that does comida caseira.
Sim. E eu gostei muito do nome do negócio dela, Cozinha da Magali.
Cozinha da Magali. So this is a person named Magali, uh-huh, who makes food at home. And then you can buy it from her.
Sim, muito legal, muito legal. E a própria imagem da Magali ali, eu fico imaginando ela cozinhando já.
There she is with a little pie in her hand and her little apron with her cherries and everything. So let's look at this poster. Again, I saw this on the house walking down the street.
Mm-hmm.
And so my guess is this is actually the house, this must be Magali's house even, where
Pode
she makes all
ser.
These other things. So let's kind of divide this poster up. Here's the top part. Que você vê aqui?
Bom, ela vende salgados e doces, né? Quando eu bati o olho nos salgados e doces, ela deve vender de tudo, não é? E nos salgados eu fiquei imaginando pastel, pastelão, empadão, lasanha, coxinha, né?
Right, so the word salgados refers to these little snack foods that you have that are salty, they're savory, right? And so among those is the pastel, empadão, lasanhas, coxinhas, those sort of things. So you can buy salgados from Magali.
E também doces.
Doces. And now these are the sweet things. So you can get either savory or sweet. And when we say doces, what are we referring to?
Brigadeiro, beijinho, mousse de maracujá e outras coisas, né?
You know, doesn't the word mousse de maracujá just make your mouth water? I love mousse de
e
maracujá.
E é muito fácil de fazer.
Yeah, man. So, by the way, I wanted to ask you, how do Brazilians say cupcake? How do you pronounce that?
Cupcake.
Cupcake.
Mm-hmm.
Cupcake.
Cupcake.
And so we're going to go a little bit more. I wanted to also show you a picture, since we're on it. This was a picture of me at a feira, doing one of my favorite feira activities, buying some pastel.
Comendo pastel. Que não é o pastel mexicano, ou seja, o pastel com a ideia do espanhol.
Ah, good point. Because when a Spanish speaker says the word pastel, they're referring to
bolo.
Bolo, a cake. When a Brazilian says pastel, it is uma massa de trigo frito.
Sim.
Right?
E é até interessante a pronúncia, né? Porque em português é pastel e no espanhol é pastel.
Oh, yeah, that whole L sort of thing.
Uh-huh.
Pastel.
E and nesse so, caso você está comendo um pastel salgado, né? Pelo
yeah,
jeito.
No, I have no, I'm under no illusion that it's not very healthy. You know, it's fried there with a bunch of junk in it. But I really, for me, a feira de rua has to have a pastel.
Tem que ter pastel, sim.
For me, that's what happens when you're out shopping.
Isso foi onde essa foto?
This was in São Paulo.
Ah, legal. Yeah. É, tem feiras muito boas
very
em São Paulo.
Very close to PUC.
Ah, bacana. Yeah. E aqui nós temos uma torta.
Right, and so here's another word which is strange. Magali also prepares a torta.
Sim.
What is your word for torta? What is a torta?
Então, torta é bolo com recheio, mas é mais recheio do que bolo.
Right, and so in English we have the difference between a cake and a pie.
Sim.
Because a pie has a filling.
Mm-hmm.
This was what the word torta refers to.
Exato.
If it's a torta, it has a filling in it.
Sim, mais recheio do que a massa em si, né?
By the way, again, our Mexican Spanish speakers, they use the word torta
for more like
a sandwich.
Isso eu aprendi aqui em Austin.
Yeah. So that'll never happen in Portuguese in Brazil.
Não.
A torta totally refers to a pie-like sort
of thing. É algo doce, não é algo.
I think your husband actually made this one in the picture, right?
Sim, uma torta de maçã.
So Eduardo, way to go! A little applauses for you there on this good-looking apple pie right there that we got. And other things that were mentioned, she does. Magali says that she makes pão de mel.
Sim. Pão de mel, ele é uma, na realidade, uma bolacha de mel, tem gosto de mel, mas como você pode ver ali na foto, você pensa, mas aonde está o mel? Bom, é o recheio, porque se cobre com chocolate.
So the honey part is on the inside, and it's all covered with chocolate on the outside.
E é uma delícia, é muito bom.
And very similar to that is another one called bem casado.
Que como o próprio nome diz, se refere ao quê? A um casamento.
Things that go well together.
É, na realidade, um docinho que você serve em casamentos e ele é uma bolachinha recheada. Então, como ele fica bem grudado, fica bem casado, é perfeito esse
Bring the
nome.
two parts together and it's filled with doce de leite, sort of thing. And so they are bem casado. They've been well married or put together. So these are all the different sorts of things that you can buy from
Magali,
Magalim.
exato.
Now let's look at the bottom part of her poster.
Bom, eu gostei que ela aceita encomendas para festas e também para congelados,
Então
né?
fala para mim um pouco a palavra encomendas. What are we referring to when Brazilians talk about
É
encomendas?
quando você liga para Magali ou você manda ali um zap para ela dizendo: olha, eu queria fazer uma encomenda de 3 tortas e 2 pães de mel.
So encomenda, like in English, we do have the word like a order by phone or order by mail. That word order, that is the encomenda,
Encomenda.
something you're
Você acha
ordering.
que o americano encomendaria alguma coisa pelo Zap?
Okay, well, notice that you got us to the next part with all these phone numbers here, and one of them is through WhatsApp. That is so cool because Brazilians use WhatsApp so much
Sim.
that they're even advertising here. If you would like to order my food,
Adiciona o número dela, manda mensagem que ela tá, vai fazer um negócio
there's
para
the
ti.
WhatsApp number to do it, the 99804.
É demais. E inclusive você pode entrar no site não, desculpa, no Facebook dela, no Face, né?
Right. Now, before we do that, let me go back to the word congelados. What
Ah,
is
sim.
that?
Congelado é comida congelada que você pode colocar no seu freezer e usar depois, no momento que você precisa, né?
So when you order something from Magali, you can order it fresh, ready to eat, or you can order it frozen,
Congelado?
congelado. And so then you can then save it in your freezer and
É demais, acho
take
que
it out
essa
whenever.
Magali é
This
um bom
Magali, she's
negócio.
got something going on here. Notice you can even use your cartão de crédito.
Ah, sim, é, ela adicionou, gostei que ela
Because a lot of
adicionou.
people don't know if they can use credit cards or not in Brazil.
Exato.
Here, she's letting you know that you can.
Ah,
As a
não.
matter of fact, it looks like it's been like a little durex. It's been taped on the
Sim,
poster
é.
to
Do
let
tipo,
you know.
olha, não se preocupe, você não tem dinheiro, tem cartão, a gente aceita cartão.
So once again, they do encomendas, both for festas or congelados. And you have all these telephone numbers, the telefone fixo or the WhatsApp that you can call. And
Ou
then we even have
Face.
her Facebook address here,
E
right?
você entrou no Facebook
I thought,
dela.
hey, there it is listed. It's a public thing. I can go look at it. And so here we are. This is her
Muito
Facebook page
legal.
of Magali. And sure enough, the day that I went in, she had a post about what sort of size of wedding cake you should get based on how many people you are serving at the wedding.
Achei muito interessante isso aí
Yeah.
também. É.
And so,
Legal. Boa
qual é
dica.
o tamanho ideal? Now I know. If you're serving 100 people, you need a 45-centimeter big wedding cake.
Legal. Ainda ela coloca ali, ó, fica a dica. Ali em cima. Eu gostei.
So for me, this was the perfect example of why I enjoy the Olhe Lá episodes. I'm walking down a street in Brazil. I see this poster of this lady who sells all of these salgados and doces. There's some words I kind of understand and don't totally understand, or things I don't appreciate. And you just come and make me aware of so many things in a poster that I wouldn't have seen otherwise. Hopefully for you listeners, that's what you got out of this episode as well, because I certainly learned a lot.
Ah, sim, e faz parte do Brasil, da língua, da cultura, é muito
Right.
interessante.
And so we have a whole bunch of these. This is part of our Olhe Lá series. You will find it in our Talking Real Portuguese YouTube site. If you could subscribe, it would make us pretty happy people.
É, se inscreve lá, deixa o seu comentário, isso é importante pra gente.
Também.
É.
With that, keep on listening because we got another one coming up. Tchau,
Até
tchau.
mais, tchau. Olha lá.